20th year, I study medicine in Ann Arbor, hundreds of miles from friends and relatives, wife and child in New York. $60 in my pocket, 9 months of work ahead. I need money. Dissection are supplied by the state. The state needs materials, humanus, for which they pay handsomely, argentus. I supply the materials with the help of my classmate. And find that doctoring is not profitus. We devise a plan for doing business. But in the form of a little trusted friend of modest means, already insured for life, increases his policy to protect his child and wife. Later on, the trusted friend begins to drink quite heavily and kills his wife and kills his child and blames it on insanity. Some months later, a body is discovered, badly decomposed. With the body is a letter, a suicide note. We split it into three. The relative, the trusted friend, my classmate and me. We need three bodies. Rigor mortis, hidden in three cities. Hide us, seek us. Too complicated. I kill my classmate instead. I use his insurance to bide my time. Known that business done with men is straight on, clean, and quickly settled. Item. Dr. Russell, a tenant in my hotel, rent due. I struck him on the head with a heavy chair. I sold his body. $45. Item. Mr. Rogers, an acquaintance from Virginia. I took him fishing and struck him on the head with the oar. Just practice. Item. Charles Cole, a southern speculator, a vicious blow crushed his head so badly that he was almost useless to the party that bought him. $1,000. I told my business partner and his son. After 7 years of practice, I carried out my plan originalis in charintradus. My glass bending furnace from him. I paid a fortune for it, a fortune, asking him to demonstrate the furnace. I locked him in it. Incineris corpus invisibilus. Fortune returnus, business expandus. Confidence of women, you learn to juggle trust. First, you set the stage, you build a hotel. Then you set a method, secret vaults, secret rooms. You employ young ladies, stenographers, cooks, waitresses. Invited her to step into my vault to retrieve a cup and tray. I closed and locked the door. She cried. She pled me to let her out. Denied. Unless she wrote a letter. For good, if she wrote the letter and release her, I would. She did. I killed her. 13 ladies, there may have been more. 13 ladies, I cannot say for sure. Minnie and Andy Williams of wealthy estate required my protection, which I freely gave. Minnie came to live with me of her own volition. My visits to Nanny ignited her suspicion. Minnie murdered Nanny. Ah, I disposed of many. Being their protector, I was their estate executor. Say for sure. Sarah Cook, her unborn child, and Mary, her account. But three for one, they became. Julie Cannon, her daughter Pearl, came to me and never came away. Danny Pytel, suffocated in a trunk. Anna Betts, Gertrude Garner, poison just for fun. Emily, my mistress, she broke my heart. I locked her in my vault and watched her slowly starve. In my restaurant, I thought I would connive to chloroform them three at once, of course to watch them die. They escaped. They ran to the authorities. Suspicions were raised. The end of my story. Spinning top and a tin man, a top coat, a trunk with a strip of blue calico mending a seam.